borrow and be able to see how you are using the law.
Uganda's growing public debt has continued to receive a lot of criticism from sections of the public. The debt currently stands at 50.3% of the gross domestic product.
You borrow to build a house, you can borrow to go and have a good time at a beach, you can borrow to go and, you know, pay school fees. It all depends on what you want to use your debt for. I think if you are going to borrow and you are actually, you know, ensuring that, you know, you have financial discipline, that then is not a problem.
Speaking to journalists today at the NGO Forum headquarters in Kampala, civil society activists under the umbrella body of the Uganda National NGO Forum urged Parliament to only approve borrowing to support projects with high economic and fiscal returns, such as infrastructure developments, hospitals and schools constructions, among others.
If you are going to borrow to be able to repair, you know, hospitals, you're going to be able to repair school infrastructure, it's a different ball game as if you are going to borrow be able to buy vehicles, because then, you know, the vehicles are not going to help you to repair the roads. I mean, you could try to buy a big car so that it can run over the potholes, but then the majority of citizens do not have those kinds of cars.
Would like part of the money being borrowed to be used on fixing the health insurance, fast tracking it to ensure that that burden is waived from Ugandans so that households can stop running bankrupt just because they have made the bill of their children.
They, however, said that it's unfortunate that most of the borrowed funds are lost through multiple public sector leakages, such as corruption and other wastages. And besides, they are worried that the government is borrowing faster than it will be able to pay.
That fire that has been put on Entebbe Airport, we need it to check all agencies of governance that have been extorting money from the people, but also where staff abuse their office.
Activists commended the public for making an alarm over the alleged extortion crisis which was taking place at Entebbe.
To be able to stop the extortion of Civil Aviation Authority workers at the airport.
With the schools preparing to resume for the first term activities, activists expressed a need for government to enforce the proposed school fee structure to ease the burden of citizens.
The degeneration at Parliament, the lack of focus at Parliament, and maybe the failure of leadership at Parliament. I am enjoining the citizens to call out Parliament, focus on issues that matter to the ordinary person, and stop their personal petty fights, which is abuse of office.
Story by Jaliet Namoya for the news.